Hey, what's going on, Coach Chris? This is part two. I already did a video talking about how to properly warm up for a bodyweight bench test or a 2¼ bench test. And now that you know how to properly warm up and prime your body to crush that test, you have to know one other thing. You gotta know how to approach your reps in the moment, in the test. And this is something that you would want to practice. You want to practice rhythm reps, and you want to practice stroke reps. And you might be looking at me like, what in the world is this guy talking about? A rep is a rep. Well, not necessarily, right? A rep is a rep if you're talking like to a one rep, you know, to an all out effort. Yeah, it's a one rep max. It's your all out effort, right? But when you're doing repetitions, repetition testing, there's speed involved, right? And as I stated in the first video, a majority of the reps you're gonna get in a bodyweight bench test or a 2¼ test is gonna come in the first like 20, 25 seconds. And then you're gonna start to hit a wall. So you know how to, you need to know how to press when you're strongest, and you need to know how to press when you're approaching failure. And that's your rhythm and your stroke reps. And breathing is very much a part of this, so listen closely. Rhythm reps are those reps that you're gonna get when you're in a groove. And there is like no time between the reps. It's just bang, 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 bang. And they're just coming, rep after rep. There is no break in tempo. Your tempo is very fluid, very consistent. Those are your rhythm reps. Really good lifters, maybe more advanced lifters, will only breathe like every 5 reps or so when they're doing their rhythm reps. Your less advanced people, you know, would be maybe every 2 or 3 reps they'd get a breath. Because again, you're not breathing that fast. No one's gonna breathe that fast. You're not gonna breathe like that while you're benching. So you can still have to, you have to rhythmically breathe while you're doing rhythm reps. Makes sense? Now, when you get to like that 25 second mark and you've already, you know, hammered out your dozen or 15 or even up to maybe 20 reps, you're gonna start to feel that fatigue hit you, right? And now is when you transition into your stroke reps. Your stroke reps is basically one rep at a time, and you're taking your breath in between each rep. So when you feel like you've gotten to that last rhythm rep, you're gonna hold the bar, right? And then reset, get a new breath, press, right? And then again, do another breath at the top, down and press, and then, so those are your stroke reps. Your stroke reps are those last like 5 reps that you're able to get because you're devoting, it's like all out effort for each rep now, right? You got that lactic acid buildup, you're coming close to the end. So you gotta make each rep count, and the only way to make each rep count is to stay tight. And that's where breathing is so important. So you never wanna be loose, you never wanna be in like, you know, trying to take a breath in while you're like lowering the weight and or whatever. You wanna take that breath in at the top so your diaphragm's filled, right? Your lungs are filled, your torso's as full and as big and as filled with tension as possible. And then that's when you can, you know, be the strongest and perform the best. Make sense? Rhythm and stroke reps. You gotta practice those. And if you get good at those and you've done the proper warm-up, I promise you, you are gonna crush a bench for a bodyweight bench test or a 2¼ like NFL style combine test. All right? Wish I knew this stuff back when I was in college, man. It would have helped me immensely. Coach Chris, Team Critical Bench, leave some comments below. I know you'll like this. It's a lot of cool information. It's just good to hear it again, you know. Time goes by, you forget some of these things, you know. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you real soon.